Hello everyone, Farfall here, this time again with another Azeroth Force cast about Pangaea. Yeah, I actually don't know if I've released now the other stuff I recorded. I kinda assume I failed at some point, because, well, what you have so far seen is at least that moment of BOTR. I hope you enjoyed that, because I took a copyright infringement for that one. But yeah, this time again, Azeroth Force Pangaea. Hopefully better than the Warhammer cast I did, because I'm actually unsure if I recorded the audio there or not. Haven't looked into those files, and I had in general a bad feeling about that cast, so... but the problems were on my side, so yeah, apologize already. What we will actually face in that mode is actually... Oh, okay, I thought for a moment it was lagging. Okay, that was also dumb on my terms. Yeah, we have, as you can see, this time a game with the 6v6 mode. And that one should be a lot more interesting and different than the 3-for-all mode we saw last time. So yeah, I hope you're actually enjoying this as well, because this will most likely be interesting and awesome, as I also enjoyed that match. Yep, as I already can tell you, I'm in that game as well. Okay, so as the first starting player and the Scourge team would be the Biswa. We have as the Burning Legion with Mal'Ganis, Thrall Shaman. Light with a random number is the Dark Horde of Outland. We have Space Hamster, most likely not the real one, if you know to whom I refer, as Garitos, of course, our Lord and Savior, whom can we not forget? Lord Garitos. Check out the proposal I made on the LTA forums, just to fuel the oil. We have Taurusson as the brave Dark Iron Dwarf, played by none other than myself. We have Jack 07 in that game, also known BOTR member, as the Might of Dalaran. We have set level 00, or double 0, I would say, as the High Elves of Quetzalas. We have Pooch, or Page, I don't know how to call that name, or spell that name. As well, this time actually properly spelled Thrall, leader of the Frostwolf clan. As you can see, the feedback has been appreciated by the map creator, thankfully. We have Angus Kirby as the Warzone clan. We have Marius Furious actually again, this time as Lightbloom. So yeah, Marius, you can't complain, now you're getting featured more often in casts. We have Dragonfly as Dark Queen and the Forces of Stormwind, Bolvar Fort Dragon at the frontline, and of course we have VTI. No, actually kidding, just a fan of VTI. But anyways, a fan of VTI here in the game. Playing the Druids with Malfurion still being at that awkward location, but yeah. Hopefully it will be a good game. I hopefully remember it well in my memory, as it was really an interesting dynamic, because as you can see, the teams are a little bit different on that one. Basically, yeah, how to spell it actually? We have here at least that team? Actually, rather it's a North vs. South fight, I would say, judging by the dynamic. And already stuff is happening down here, where just some creeps are attacking the Warsong camp, okay. So we still have the vision issues while Angus is dealing with those. But yeah, basically it's a North vs. South fight, where actually here our guys of the normal evil team in Azeroth Wars, I actually don't find any words today, I've realized, yeah, actually taking the burden up to fight here in the north, which I first thought it was kinda unbalanced, but surprisingly it turned out pretty well, and nonetheless those players, yeah, we will see, it has some own dynamic, I even can't really foresee that much. Yeah, at the same time already Teal and myself making the first move, Thorsten is actually pretty awesome. Or at least he was pretty OP in that version, because, wait a minute, he has the Brilliance Aura, and I definitely remember that Flamestrike, which we also might see, and I mean, holy shit, that one. That Flamestrike is really, really bad. You should never give me a Flamestrike. I actually don't know what that base is, by the way, if that is the Dark Iron base, because I talked to the creator, who was it? Dragonfly, yeah, Dragonfly this time playing as Dark Queen. He actually I actually don't know what he told me. Oh, and hey, that one is bringing itself into position with those magic cannons. Still hasn't changed that model. But at the same time, oh, Burning Legion already making a push for them. While I'm not really ready, I'm just waiting there at Loch Modan. And at the same time, oh, repelling an attack of Dark Queen. Varian Wyn, really, really wounded. And yeah, here are those Outriders, basically knights, as I told on the forums, but I guess the creator also has fixed that issue as well. Because, let's be honest, the... yeah, mayhaps you will see it in that game, because as we already watched in the other game, you can spam Outriders pretty easily. Dragonfly is going more for a mixed composition, which is actually good, which I actually recommend every Dark Queen player to actually go for, even in normal as it was. Oh! While at the same time, okay, I thought the troops were flanking, but yeah. The combined might of the Dark Iron Dwarfs and the Dark Horde are repelling the Stormwind troops, while battles are actually developing itself in the north, yeah. Yeah, High Elves are actually taking up stuff here, attacking also the Legion base up here. While Space Hamster, Space Hamster tries to defend, and Beastwise is actually attacking, so battle for Enderhall. That one should be also pretty exciting. But, oh! It should be exciting, unless, of course, the Beastwise does not leave the game, which apparently happened. Beastwise, is there actually any reason why you leave the game? I mean, you did not disconnect, but yeah. As Angus said, get wrecked. Angus, speaking of you, mate, what are you doing? You're currently waiting. Ah, okay. Oh yeah, that's right, yeah, because you have to fight the Night Elves, combined might of Marius and his ally VTI fan. VTI? I actually don't know what are you doing. Or rather, you're a fan of VTI. Chilling down there. Canaris riding bravely down, followed by a ballista. Yep, it's good. Good. Actually, I don't know if he knows what to do actually in that game. But yeah. And Angus definitely has a plan. He's already massing out troops. He's definitely preparing to take Mount Hyjal and the surrounding lands, while at the same time, Jack? Oh! Having already lost Jaina. Oh yeah, that's right, because I pushed also out. I'm basically fighting at two fronts, people. Ladies and gentlemen, Dwarfs are the OP master faction of that game. I can tell you that, because I can fight at the same time up here, I can fight down here in Stormwind as well, if I want to. And I can heal the living shit out of McTavidon and his forces. Why? Oh, Maggie! See, in a normal Azure Wars, that fight would already be lost by Teal, since Maggie is not revivable, but in that version, he's already lucky that he can revive Maggie, so it's fine. Thus, it's fine. At the same time, Rand Blackhand is getting out. Meanwhile, myself, I actually don't know. Because I was really tired during that situation. If I was doing fine in the north or not, apparently I did not do fine. So yeah, Dalaran steamrolled me and I actually realized and retreated. Oh yeah, that will be really, really lovely. At the same time, yeah, Legion has to see what they are doing since Space Hamster is invading. Actually, one of the Dreadlords leveling up, that's good. Yeah, Skolomance pretty much gets cleared out. Even so, Blue is still producing stuff, or someone at least, so the Beastwa's position here can be held. Oh, we saw that one on Rand, but he died too quickly. Yep, at the gates of Stormwind. So, Dark Queen definitely knows how to hold. Even so, actually the Zeppelins shouldn't do all... Yeah, actually... The Zeppelin should be fine. They look kinda weak for a siege unit, I have to say, but... Might only be me. Oh well. Might only be myself. Okay, so at the same time... pushing back Orange since he tried to invade. And here's actually the problem of that Dalaran position. Since there's a newly added portal and... Oh yeah, and we haven't mentioned that Dalaran got a new redesign. Thing is, see all those towers, right? If you try to attack, thing is, units automatically move inside the portal. Right here, where you can actually basically gank up on them if you're orange. So that creates definitely some passing issues. which you don't want to have, and here, shamefully, Towson goes down because I did not realize it in time, so yeah. Oof. Even so, bad play on my side, of course. I mean, theoretically, I guess I could have told my guys to move here and hold position, but still, it's kind of annoying, if you ask me, so... Plus 4 melee units, you don't have any real solution. Thus I would recommend, remove that part, make a proper gate out of it, or even an entrance. I mean, that place is already heavily fortified. I mean, you can even leave the towers how they are, so... Yeah, and then it should actually be fine. I mean, also, Dalaran is really a hard position to take with two teleporters. I mean, they already have a teleporter and newly added the dungeons, which also look kinda beautiful, I have to say, compared to the rest of the map. Like, seriously, I actually love that terrain. I mean, yeah, tile variation is not all too good, but, I don't know, I am just in love with all these pillars here, the pillar design. It really makes out a lot of this place, so, yeah. Actually, that's what I like most. Well, at the same time, Red got defeated. Actually, I have to say, yeah, Frozen Throne is still standing, but the question is, of course, as usual, for how long, because yeah, Queen is moving up there, since he dealt with Blue Space. Speaking of, oh yeah, yeah, here they go. So, Blue definitely is currently out of the game, you might say, but as we all know from the recent game, they will get now their second chances, thus making the game in team mode kind of balanced in my opinion, basically because you, wait a minute, at least for the South team it's kind of balanced, because they get... where is that place? God damn it, there it is, yeah, Anchorage. Oh, and here they already got it. So yeah, here they can actually get all their stuff, while Patch is actually at the same time clearing out Prawn Space here. Speaking of oh yeah, they are already first fights. Kirby, what are you doing? Ah, Kirby is pushing towards Ashenvale, but at the same time, Pawn can actually flank. Even so, I actually don't know where your army is. Oh, Marius actually had to retreat? Okay, so I guess he did not fought the Warsong host. But yeah, oh, now we see the Tigers in action. Yeah, Tigers! Speaking about the Tigers, they're not really good tanky melee units compared to the Ogres. And the Warsong Outriders, so yeah, I guess those will die quite fast, even so. Yeah, partly they're currently doing damage, but I mean with Rexha and Chrom at the... Oh, Chrom at the backline! Oh, that will hurt, Maris, that will hurt. Oh, definitely, I see the damage on the archers, my god. That whirlwind. Be careful though with Chrom, but since he has Windwalk, he can actually escape pretty easily out of battle, so he should be fine. Oh, and that siege unit is die. Oh, I see it. Yep. Yeah. I would have been surprised if he would have let that one escape, actually. So, yeah. You have towers, Marius. You know that? These obelisks? I guess you realized. Oh, well. But, yeah. Marius fighting on a kind of lost position while the... Hort under Chrom Hellscream, or rather the Warsong clan, is now taking his lands. I'm also quite unsure where he wishes to hold, because for my... well, he could hold there and may have muster force up here. But I actually don't know what he has here, otherwise. Mario... Yes, theoretically he would have Maiev, but Maiev is not out yet. Or rather she died, and he has to revive her. Does not seem like that, and he also doesn't have the resources to do it, so... I guess we won't see Maiev again, for now. Tyrant, Tyrant pretty low. So, okay. I like that play. I really like that. Okay. Yeah, but that battle should be already over, so we actually can skip up to another scene where we see, yeah, Lion's taking that stuff. Someone is still spamming Red's forces, so yeah, so Queen's ambush can actually be stopped. I like that, actually. That's good. Oh, and Tyrande died. Oh, while at the same time, The Alliance of Lordaeron is aiding in the battle. Nice! I love that team play. See, that's what I mean about different dynamics. You have defeated one frontline, but at the same time, when another one is opening up, you can actually act up. But that's the same. Oh, Angus. Ah, okay. For a moment, I thought Pawn was not reacting, but apparently Angus also sent up some forces here, so. Yeah, Pawn was kinda occupied. Even so, you should be on a good amount of money, I guess, or are you fighting somewhere? Yeah, actually, you have. Ah, oh, actually, you are creating force, but you're just careful with your money. Oh, never mind, never mind. Maybe you're doing that tactical. Maybe I underestimate you. So, wondering what Pudge is. Oh! Pudge is actually coming in for the assault on Nidalee. Ah! Not Nidalee one, but on Old Dalaran one. See, I'm really confused with stuff and concerns LTA. And yep! Oh, but be careful. Yeah, but here, see, here's the passing issue, kinda. Oh, well, at the same time, actually, Knights of Stormwind are also trying to flank. I actually realize they have the same knights, like, yeah, like in Stormwind, right at the same time. Oh, I guess we are also pushing on an attack, so. Ah, yeah, and here some of my stuff got stuck, like. Here you actually have to set passing blockers, yeah, because of the mountain area. But either way, yeah, actually. Oh, yeah, that will be nice, because at the same time, see, there's my tactic again that I actually try to support up here against Dalaran, while at the same time heading down here in Stormwind in hope to actually break through. Even have a beer wagon here. Okay, so the Sentinel Tower is also going down in Westfall, wasn't it? I guess it was Westfall. While the Horde is actually pillaging all those lands around Stormwind, yeah. Where was he? Not that. Oh, Rand actually chasing down an elite, I guess. Not the High King of Stormwind. Ah, there he is. There he is. Holy shit! Minus 20 damage. Oh, because of that Howl of Terror effect. Okay, so an unit has actually Howl of Terror, which can reduce 20 damage. I actually don't know if that effect is that good. Or whether it should, or it should be supposed to be like that. Like, I mean, I assume that one is on Maxeridon, and seems kind of powerful if you ask me. But hey, whom am I to judge? But at the same time, by the way, those invisible Arachnotites are like, yeah, really invisible. Love it. Yeah, but people are actually pretty hesitant when it comes to spending money. Either that or they get a lot. I mean, I have to judge. Yeah, actually, okay. Never mind. Yeah. And again, we actually got repelled up here, even though you might think you actually won that battle on New Dalaran. Always keep saying New Dalaran, but it's old one. But yeah, yeah. I guess you see what the problem is. Okay, never mind. I'm actually fully invading south while keeping north for now at least unprotected. Mayhaps that might be a mistake, mayhaps not. Queen in the meantime. Oh, and Mary's actually having fled to Eastern Kingdoms. I have to actually see how the alliance fares. I mean, oh, actually, they still have here a base. Yeah, their stuff, while fighting very much was. Oh yeah, that's right, because Forsaken got launched, yeah. And those forces are now settled down in Gilneas, so these will be pretty valuable when it comes to new assaults on New Dalaran. While at the same time, oh god! Oh no, wait, actually that's Bluff's forces, never mind. I thought for a moment this is an invasion, but the invasion might come sooner than you might think, so. Yeah, I actually like how Purple is doing. Like, Space Hamster really cares for his allies. He's really everywhere and nowhere at all. Nah, actually not nowhere, but he's really everywhere. I love that. Oh, but at the same time, Warzone Clan is preaching through the gaps of VTI fan. Oh god. Yeah, hold. Actually, you haven't taken Jadena? Okay. That might be now problematic mid-battle. So, Guess you, yeah, guess you should be careful. And I actually don't know if spamming furbolgs is the right strategy in that one. I mean, if I would get a chance to click on one. Yeah, actually there they are, but they don't actually look pretty tanky if you ask me. Maybe buff those? Actually can't judge it because right now it really seems like the Horde is doing everything right, and I mean, let's be honest, they upgraded also, so yeah, don't know on what Prawn spent his money so far, except for Furbolgs. Yeah, no upgrades at all. Might be reasonable that those go down. I mean, yeah. Oh, but he towered himself up at Mount Hyjal and is still towering. Okay, never mind. So, yeah, but on long terms this tactic won't help him because Kirby knows what he's doing. Meanwhile, oh! The Alliance tries to break through the domain of the Warsong Hold, but actually gets repelled because Pink is also keeping his watch there, so there it goes actually. And at the same time, I actually remember I did that. Yeah, because at that point I actually utilized stuff from Red. Or even so, yeah, actually I don't remember that much controls, so it might be also the case that an additional player also microed that one, so good job on that. Same time, Blue is also invading Dalaran, since Dalaran is stuck here. And yeah, the opportunity is just golden to rape that city, like a golden fruit. Oh, Antonidas, Antonidas, oh god, my good sir Antonidas, yeah, see? Just remaining in your city won't help you further. Oh, where it's this? Holy shit! That city has... Wow. Really? That city has some kind of big bad voodoo? Oh my god! Okay, that's insane, actually. I have to say, I do not like that choice. Or rather, I don't agree to that, because, I mean, let's face it, Dalaran's is as invulnerable as long as the generator stands, and by making all units invulnerable. That's the no. You can't do that. Oh, come on. That's oh, that's too powerful. That's really too powerful. Because let's be honest, I mean, that way you can just slaughter any invader. I mean, it takes such a long time. Wow. Holy. Is it bugged or... No, actually not. Okay, never mind. But still, that one... I would actually recommend to remove that one. Because anti-undead aura is fine. I mean, it even works. Should actually see that... should be somewhere here. But yeah. Definitely. But Dalaran should not be able to actually do that. My god, okay. Have discovered something new I have not realized. Okay. Yeah, but as said, helpful advice. At the same time, we missed the siege of Mount Hyjal, even though I don't think it was that brutal or at least that. Yeah, interesting. I mean, okay. Truth to be told, he now produced some chimeras, which mayhaps could have done something in that battle, but so far I don't see it. While at the same time, yeah. That attack of Lordaeron and Queen did not work out as planned. Oh, Marius also here. Yeah, actually, Marius, do you still possess your stuff? God damn it, that damn arrow. I do not like that. Yeah, he actually does. He actually does. He does just not utilize it, so... It's fine. It's fine, I guess. And he has the key to the Tomb of the Garrus in his possession, so theoretically he could open it. Technically, the Northern Alliance would actually benefit from that key, since, yeah, it's actually close to them. Okay, but so far they're holding here, so that should be fine. Oh, and they also have furbox. Okay, but never mind, those are upgraded ones. So I thought for a moment these are a bit stronger than Prawn ones, I wanted to say, but yeah. Yeah, either way, a frontline was created here. Dalaran is now near the fall so far. While actually still having solely relying on the dungeons. Oh, actually, never mind. Marius is actually utilizing his stuff. So, never mind. At the same time, with other front lines, yeah, I mean, I have, oh no, actually, Queen has some stuff here. Oh, but at the same time, Dragonfly has lost Stormwind already. Yeah, cleared Stormwind. We're missing all the important base clears. Base clears, clearances, actually, I don't know what term to actually find for that, but yeah. Now, actually, Dragonfly relies on Swarmguard, his second chance. So, yeah, those also are getting spawned in. And my god, I actually have to drink. Oh god. Yeah, I should hurry with drinking because Maiev is in a battle, yeah! Oh my god. Yeah, so here it comes again. Pink flanking actually from the northern side. Ah, moving around here at Ashaba, which is quite good. So, they can actually put a battle up with purple. Usa's Lightbringer and Lord Garritos turned into a mere hair. My god. That insult. Ugh. Lord Garritos turned into a rabbit. Shame on you. Oh, was that? No, actually. Yeah, Usa is still alive. Okay, never mind. That was just a normal paladin. Swell should be a little bit careful because purple really knows how to utilize his hero squad. I love that. I love that. Maiev also at the front lines. Tyrande at level 7, actually. Okay. So, Maris is also doing a good job, at least with his hero squad, love that. Yeah, Patches Ogres won't make a difference. Oh, while at the same time, the Nerubian Queens of Bloom also kind of participating in that battle, summoning up skeletons, which damage the siege lines of Purple, yeah. Yeah, it's hard to tell because Dark Queen also has the catapults. Yeah, same time I besiege, of course, Darkwing stuff, and oh, here are also some passing issues. Yeah, basically because those wood trolls are also attacking up here. Yeah, as I said. Vision-wise, you really have to use some vision blockers up here in that mountain area, so people can't actually go up there, or... Yeah, and passing blockers, of course. Always rely on the passing blockers. If you need help on that, just tell me. I can actually give you some help on that. Northern area quite silent since nobody's really utilizing it. And oh, Queen actually possessing those dragons. So that's also nice to see. That's also nice to see. I actually don't know what I wanted to look at. Oh, actually, that area also has now some new stuff, I realize. Holy shit, yeah, actually, that... looks kinda strange, but that Dragonmore port actually looks kinda interesting. Oh! But big battle again. I just love that map for those small big battles sometimes, because, I mean, in the last part, yeah, I said it's too many units, but I don't know, it's some kind own unique dynamic in team mode, because you actually have no purpose with those armies, my god. And in the other game it was like, yeah, I'm attacking that random faction, and oh yeah, other random faction is attacking me back, so... Actually, I see... my god, my voice. Guys, can you be it? Can you be it? But either way, before I hyper-react on that one... oh yeah, and I'm now putting pressure on Dragonfly here. Yeah, as I said, the team dynamic in that game, it's really, really awesome and great, and I really would love to celebrate that even more. Because, let's be honest, that's just nice to have. To see actually a game being utilized in that direction, and yes, they, yeah, I would rather rely on the team modes than on the free-for-all mode, because those are obviously more fun to play, and also more cast-worthy, to be honest, as far as I can tell. Oh, yeah, but Maris got sniped on his last base. I guess he does not have all too much bases now, so the southern team are actually so far on the move. Oh. But he could save some wisps, and oh! Illidan is also getting launched by Brown. Yeah, okay, so that's his second chance, I guess. I actually don't know where that's getting launched exactly, but... I guess he will also have a base here. Oh yeah, that's right, Zagaron, I forgot. With all the Satyrs and... Bloodmothers, and yeah. So that's also kind of an interesting area. Angus actually having some Dryads down there, which get killed off by creeps, but yeah. Oh, and Maris most likely is realizing that he can actually take creep camps. While Illidan is harassing the force of the Warsong Clan. Actually a nice tactic like that one. I definitely appreciate to that. Oh, and apparently it's Pawn's Force? Never mind. Okay, so he actually got Naga Base. Oh, never mind. I thought he just had Tyrande, but actually that's cool in the team mode, I have to say. Because that way Illidan has the Satyrs and yeah, actually Lightblue is controlled by Lady Vash. Okay, I like that dynamic. Actually that's superior to normal Azure Force in my opinion, at some point at least. Yeah, Stormguard is still standing. We already have established the frontline here. Nothing will escape from that position. Even so, it's hard to break. I have to say that. Most likely, I guess, because of those towers. but here you see the insane flame strike melting down buildings. Holy shit. Yeah, so Rand also dying, I guess, because he walked into my flame strike. But yeah. Yeah, and as said, the Outrider spam in that one is really, really superior. The elites are actually kinda stronger, I guess. At least they got one upgrade, making them thus a little bit harder to bear. But at the same time, mortar teams are besieging the gates of Stormguard, and oh, that snipe though. Just see that. I love that snipe. I actually don't know why I trained that one, apart from scouting reasons. Yeah. Oh, and an entire army got stuck here just on the mountain line because I trained it from here. Yeah, see? I mean, those actually moved correctly, but never mind. Yeah, see? Here's the gap. Here's definitely the gap. Units don't know where to walk, actually. And that was my main concern during the entire game, that I actually wondered why I have so few forces, and then I just realized, oh hey, yep, they are all stuck on a mountain, and that's not few forces, to be honest. So yeah. Northern team, not looking good at all, while at the same time, Cultivars got launched. Okay, so Borulus is also now in the game. Speaking of Borulus, that's another thing. Some people, I actually don't know who actually took Old Dalaran, but some people actually did not realize that the Violet Hold was still standing, so they thought it was a bug, I guess. Either way, I knew about the dungeon, thus I, yeah. So it's not pretty obvious that there's also a teleporter leading down there, since you only focusing on their teleporter, so yeah. Mayhaps that's confusing people. But at the same time, my god, this is an eternal battlefield between the North Alliance and the Force of Ankh-Morpork and the Scourge. Or not the Scourge anymore, the Forsaken. And Pink. Pink as well. Yeah, the map is great. The map is great. You have chances to come back. You have chances to actually break in new front lines into the game. While at the same time, the Naga are now harassing Pucci's territory. I guess that was the moment when Maris thought, oh yeah, he found the super race with second chance, but I can't guarantee for that one. Either way, forces of blue partly repelled, pink's forces also pretty much decimated. He had larger forces. So actually credits to Space Hamster for holding out, even oh god, the aim on that elite. Oh god, will it make it out? Okay. He actually makes it out with all elites. My god, yeah, I love that. And tying blue into a battle again. Retreating a bit, healing up forces. Oh yeah, that's golden. That's good. Superb gameplay at every border. And here's a Naga Myrmidon on Quay's side. So yeah. Maris is not the only one possessing Nagas. You just can't train them faster, that's all. Yeah. Yeah, but at the same time, I guess here's the problem. Maris should know, he can normally do stuff with armies. And in that case, I guess he could have made a return into the game, but, yeah. But if you're running away, I guess that doesn't help at all, so... Yeah. Van Player can't, messing up those guards up here. Oh, well. But yeah, at the same time, Siege for Stromgarde still standing here, while I prepare my forces to actually... Yeah, to actually fight here. I mean, Dalaran even brought up his host again, and thus I took it for a reason to actually place down here some stuff, because I did not realize people did not kill off the stuff in the dungeon. I later on just made a wild guess, so yeah. So had to hold here together with Maxeldon. Maxeldon kinda standing awkwardly here at the mountainside, being like, yeah, good, I would like to move out, but I'm blocked, but hey, yeah. It's balanced. I do not agree, Maris. I do not agree. Oh, yeah, and that's right, because, by the way, what's that island? I'm pretty sure I don't remember that island. I actually don't know what that is. I know that, oh, a mysterious rock? Oh, okay, that's also nice. I actually know that Teal is supposed to have here his second chance, but I do not remember that island from lore, honestly. If people can enlighten me, that would be great. But yeah, actually, Naga units walking over the sea, I guess that's, that might be an issue, so I did not thought about that one. And I kind of remember I mentioned it during the game itself, that it is an issue, but, yeah. I don't know how the editor Dragonfly is actually looking at that, but at the same time, another attempt to actually take Stormguard. Maxeldon this time looking more superior, having actually good damage. I mean, not as OP as Pudget Abandus in LTA, for example, but hey, it's okay. But at the same time, I actually try to break through here. Dragonfly tries to repair at every front where he can, but yeah. Won't have any use. Yeah, Varian. Yeah, I actually don't know if Varian is escaping that battle, but. And I actually don't know where I'm moving those forces. Still haven't realized that their forces are stuck, so. Yeah, that happens. So, yeah. Oh, but I actually removed down here a barracks, so. My stuff wasn't stuck, so... Even though I don't remember when I did it exactly... Oh, whoops. Ah, okay, so Dragonfly thinks it's a good idea to make a return into this position again. I mean... Oh no, wait, actually he can't escape, so he is actually forced to fight up there. So yeah, either hold or die. That's it, the last final stand of Dark Queen. While the OP beer wagons are healing up the Dark Horde, my tanks are also standing here, proudly, bravely, doing stuff. Oh, and Jaina is also here to trying to save the day. I'm not sure about that. I'm not sure. Meanwhile, I'm throwing more red forces to the portals, so people can't just actually escape or pump out more stuff out of New Dalaran. Making also... anti-camping auras around the portal, as I suggested on the forum, also good idea. I actually don't know if that got implemented, because I suggested it on the forum. Might already be the case. Oh, and I see people are already running out of food limit. Marius got... Yeah, Marius' base got destroyed. Zagaron also got taken, I guess. Then, no, actually... yeah, that base. There it is. And Zagaron got taken by Angus, yeah. So, Angus is making... some progress. He already obtained Chance Stormstored for the level 15 or level 18 hero. I actually don't know who it is. Oh, and we missed actually that Lordaeron got also raised to the crowns, or is currently getting raised to the crowns. Where's Space Hamster? Space Hamster has lost God Garitos, has to retreat to Stratom. So yeah, staff is not looking happy at all. Where was my lovely, lovely Strumguard? Yeah, there it is. And actually, Dragonfly could surprisingly repel that attack, but the question is for how long. Basically, since yeah. I mean, it's all for them, and oh yeah, here they try to flee actually. Yeah, and they actually make it out, because, let's be honest, they won mayhaps the fight over the city, but in the end, during the next assault, it would be lost anyway. So yeah, that actually was a good choice. Yeah, because here is Dark Horde coming, taking out that area, so yeah! Our Northern Alliance! I mean, not all second chances have been launched, and oh my god, okay. So, Baylor is also second chance, or some kind of... I actually don't know what that is. But, so far it seems okay. Baylor, I kinda... Mayhaps I remember that one. Mayhaps I remember that one. Wasn't that an island, also next to Stormwind, western of it, on the western coast. Oh well. But yeah. So... yeah, basically it's already a win. For those who already just came here to see who will actually win the game, I guess... that's already the end. Yeah. Because the thing is, when looking at our glorious... yeah, I mean... we control already nearly the entire continent. I mean, 3/4 of that, or 3/4, you would rather say in English. Yeah, that's hard to compete, I guess. Oh, but still 4 strategies, Hawks attacking the siege. Oh, I love that one. That's a good move. I also tend to do that one in LTA as much as I can. Even so, not all the siege was taken out, only a few things. Yeah, but Purple has to retreat even furthermore into Quetzalas. Stuff is now... yeah. I mean, barracks are built. Sunville area is now getting defended. Oh yeah, and that's right, and he has to ascend. And oh my god, yeah, a lot of stuff is now getting sent. Well, that's the same... oh, Alex sent for Smoke Rain. So, his second chance got lost. Not lost, but launched with the fall of Stratholme. Nice, 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 nice. And there was also a passing issue, I saw that one. Yeah, so it still has potential to turn. Tides of War still can turn. While at the same time, if I see that right, yeah, we already killed off that area, as I realized, yeah, there was still the core of Dalaran alive. And that area also got cleared off. So, in the end, Jack tried to defend, but... yeah. Dalaran was already lost. New Dalaran got launched. Thus, he actually has to defend there against the force of Karen Bloodhoof, as Pink is also moving into that territory, taking Uldur first. Or rather, Yuxa won. Oh my god, yeah. That's unfortunate timing. That's really unfortunate. While... even so, this base is getting ignored since the, that base, the, Questworks did not get launched. So, yeah. I guess, like in LTA, nobody pays attention for cultivars with the misspelled Boalus, but yeah. But at the same time, Scarlet Knights are trying to retake Lord One. Actually, ooh, those actually look quite more buffed than the Knights Dark Queen have. Yeah, Dark Queen also has his forces here, contributing his stuff to the fight here. While, yeah, at the same time, stuff is moving up. Even now, my tanks come. So, yeah. It will be pretty hard now. Oh yeah, and I also tried to build an Altar of Kings since Tosan also died somewhere else. And my god, units are always getting stuck here. Ah. but at least I managed to move them out here, so... Yeah. God. It's always the same issue. Always passing issues, which block my nice strategies. Okay, so that base is also getting retaken by these outriders. And yeah, they also get the Reliance Keep now, since I forgot to mention. So yeah, that one will also be pretty valuable in their fight. Actually wonder when the Warsong expedition gets launched. I guess when Kray enters that area. Huh. Might be soon. Might be soon. Yeah. Either way, Wyrmwest Accord now under Purple's control, while at the same time Patch actually moving up to the Frozen Throne area. Okay, there's actually okay, so there's actually some item with necromancy. Foiland of Sacrifice, or Tome of Sacrifice, I guess, if you translate it. Oh god. And yeah, here comes the battle again. Red getting pushed in here. While the forces of Thrall Shaman are fighting through stuff. Yeah, the balancing is mayhaps not the best one on the team fights, but nonetheless, I enjoy the dynamic. Dynamic so far is kind of promising, and I personally think the team fights are more balanced out than the free for all, since factions rely on each other. Plus, even in the LTA games, when you have a 6v6 match, fun actually relies on not on the team fights, but rather on yeah, actually the imbalance of a good versus evil match. That's what I wanted to say. Okay. But yeah, so got repelled again. Admiral Portmore holding Brave while Lady Varsh has fallen. Oh, oh god, dark, dark days while dwarves are running up. Actually, yeah, there's a dwarven house sampling here. Taking all the stuff they can. And yeah. Yeah, but like in the free for all game, Lordwyn is just a ruin. I mean, nothing is here, no fortress at all. And oh, Marius called it a game already. Patch call. Oh, Patch also left the game. So I guess it's called a game then, yeah. Basically, since the only remaining place they have is just Quetzalas, actually New Dalaran as well, even so nobody bothered with taking that one. But yeah. Yeah, so I guess I would love to end the cast here. Actually, never mind. We just look into that last battle, since these two players left. Oh, and we actually see the team resources here. I did not realize. At least something good, have to say that. Yeah, but actually on that last spot it seems like the force of the North Alliance can at least hold the borders of Quel'Thalas, so that's at least something. That's at least an improvement. Where's actually... Ah, there's Taurus Sun. I just wanted to ask where my lovely, lovely level 12 Taurus Sun is. I mean, he has that lovely, lovely flame strike. Ooh, yep. Yeah, it gets casted. Yeah, there it goes. Okay, never mind. I thought for a moment it would be right there in that area, but apparently I casted it here. So, yeah. Oh, and oh, the aim is going down here, but I can escape with my nice, nice friend Taurus-san here before he gets aimed down. So, yeah. Blue stuff is quite strong, so I have to say that. Even on second chance, Rifleman. Actually not on high upgrades, to be honest. I could do better on that, of course, but yeah. Oh, and Vaukan also died. So yeah, actually, I guess barely a setback, since yeah, I mean, game is kind of won. Yeah, because Warsong is now flanking. So yeah. So yeah. Oh well. See, I just wanted to end the cast and now I'm not ending it. So, well. Let's see how Angus is doing. I mean, he also has a part to say into this, so yeah. Oh, okay. Myself microing out a lot of stuff to get rid of those outriders. And keeping Worm with the court, so that should be fine. Yeah. And at the same time, Dark Horde has landed, so that definitely should break their neck, since they have to fight now on two fronts. Angus is now approaching, and we will at least see a last siege of Quetzalas. Well, that's oh my god, yeah, shamefully getting murdered in the back. Ah, I hate that. But yeah, oh, the gate went down. Okay. Yeah, maybe I just did bad in that other game where I played against Queen, but still. I kind of think the issue still remains with these buildings here. Don't know why. Because even now they are blocking Maxeridon's force, even though they wanted to storm in and gave Dark Queen and Queen enough time to actually retreat to the last level of the Sun Well. I guess even they could have held there if they would have more forces here. But yeah. I mean, it's the last days of the Alliance and they shall fall at that day. Smoke Queen also? Oh no, actually not. He's down here at Tyrsand, but he has no stuff left. Actually, he has. He has the Scarlet Onslaught. Oh, and the Ashbringer up here. Okay. So, that's also interesting to know. So. But I guess they won't make any difference when it comes to taking the Sun Well. Ooh. Holy shit. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay, those Naga are not from Marius, since Marius called it a game already, but from Angus. Oh my god. Now they're really desperate. Oh! Keltas teleporting out, I guess so. Yeah, but to where did they teleport? Wait a minute, I have to see. Oh, wait a minute, it's not Keltas, but Anastarion. Yeah, they teleported to Boulos, even though he should know that he will lose now once the Sun Well falls. Keltas, or rather, when Silvermoon falls. Yeah. He will lose Anastarion and exchange him for Keltas. Okay. Don't know how I screwed that up, but yeah. Oh, and at the same time, I'm taking Udalawan. So. Yeah, this time it's by the way correct. New Udalawan. I actually don't know why that vault site is, by the way, open. Don't get it. Mayhaps it was a mistake in editing. I did for sure not kill the... What did I? I don't remember. But either way, that vault site... Kind of... Not anyways. So, yeah. Silvermoon getting slaughtered off. Sunwell invulnerable. Chance Darmstored looking happy. Bloodlust enraged. Edit. And now the High Elves return into the Blood Elves. So yeah, that's it. That's the game. While we can look at it from the perspective of the other Alliance. Yep. I mean, damage-wise, they kept, or at least our team kept a lot of their old territory. And oh, Angus actually... Or at least here also is some passing issues, even though Angus did not use this stuff. Space Hamster called it a game, it's GG already, and yeah. I guess that was it. Oh yeah, right, they have to take the Sunwell first because... Oh, before Queen actually becomes now the Blood Elf, so yeah, here it goes. Here is Keltas. That was it. So yeah. I actually hope you enjoyed it. Well, yes, theoretically I could also just show you the fall of New Dalaran, but I guess it wouldn't be worth it since we all know how that game ends. So far, I guess what the last stuff is, what actually happens in that replay, is apparently us, a little bit talking, just doing some weird stuff, etc. I guess I even built up some barracks here to reinforce at that place to eventually take New Dalaran, since, I don't know, I guess Jack will defend it, and I had to build some barracks there, or... Yeah, and we'll reinforce, so yeah, actually... There won't happen all too much, just some random stuff where I will actually take stuff here, like for example Karazhan, which I have already taken, and I will actually run up here and take also there some stuff. Ulderman I guess I will also take, so yeah, not all too interesting, but yeah, I hope you enjoyed it nonetheless, I hope you liked that cast. And if you want to see more Azeroth Wars Pangaea, just write it in the comments, send me replays if you can by any time. I will try to cast it. Also, you can write down your opinion on Azeroth Wars Pangaea, because we all know, yeah, it's not the most perfect project, it's probably not the best map out there, but it's making progress, and that's not even the newest version. There's even a new version out, it might already have fixed what I also criticized in that version, like for example the Torsen Flamestrike is also lowered, I guess the Outrider concept I proposed was also overtaken and other stuff happened, so yeah, it shouldn't be too bad. So yeah, that was it so far, leave a like, leave a comment, I repeat myself, so yeah, see you next time, bye!